When we use the tree respectfully and economically, we have one of the greatest resources on earth, said Frank Lloyd Wright. Namaste and a happy morning to one and all present here. The dawn of the day opens to a variety of noises from our environment. It could be the chirping of the birds, the cooing of the crow, the noises of crickets, the call of the parakeets, the squeaking of the squirrel, etc. But these noises ring an alarm to wake us up. On the contrary, can you imagine waking up to the silence? Man's bonding with nature has been for ages. It was he who got connected with nature, as it is believed that nature has always been there from time immemorial. Man's harmony with nature made life easier. He explored, later exploited, and when this reached the ultimate boundary, nature reacted. The balance was in trouble. Slowly, he learned to revert to nature, respecting and taking care of it. But this care is not just one man's deed, it is a collective need. Thus, the World Environment Day is celebrated every year on June 5th to encourage worldwide awareness and action for the protection of the environment, and is set as a reminder to alert man to save his race and his planet to sustain. On this special day, it is my pleasure to introduce the guest of the day, Ms. Deepa Ananda Padmanabhan, who expertise lies in the area of education, environment education and social entrepreneurship. A teacher by profession, she is one of the founders of Sarsar Charitable Society based at Trivandrum, which works in community volunteering at Sastra Foundation, working in climate change and suitable development. She has been working on educating children and youth about our environment and the need for sustainability, which includes awareness on gender poverty. She is the co-founder of Bhava Social Venture, which aims at proving sustainable alternatives to daily living products, at the same time creating livelihood for rural and urban women. Let us lend our ears to her words on this special occasion.
Good morning, dear children. Wish you all a wonderful Environment Day. Why are we celebrating an Environment Day? It is to remind ourselves how important the planet is to us, how important the ecosystem we live in is to us. So, coming to an interesting word, ecosystem. We have so many kinds of ecosystem around us. Forests, oceans, the grasslands, the peatlands, the freshwater bodies. All these, the deserts, they are amazing places which make our living on this planet possible. And they give us such amazing services, the ecosystem services. I'm sure you're aware of that. From the tiny bee that pollinates and creates amazing forests, to the oceans that by daily taking part in the water cycle give us the precious resource of water. From the glaciers that melt to fill the rivers which support our farmers. Each of these are ecosystem providers. And we are a tiny part of the same ecosystem. But are we adding value to it? That is the most important question we have to address, my dear friends. We, the human beings, in the name of progress and development, instead of adding value, have been degrading the ecosystem. We have created a new ecosystem, the urban spaces. And we are impacting not just the planet, but scores of vulnerable people through our actions. It is high time that we took stock and are more mindful of our daily living. And what can we do about it? The United Nations and the governments of the world have put forth the Sustainable Development Goals, wherein hopefully by 2030, there will be less poverty, no hunger, clean water and sanitation for all. Life on water and earth is taken care of, mainly the flora and fauna. There is more gender parity. Such goals are going to be addressed and we all have to be working towards it. That is why the United Nations will be kick-starting the decade of ecosystem restoration coming today. And we all have to take part in this restoration project. Some of the bigger examples are the Green Wall project, in Great Green Wall project in Africa, and Pakistan's 10 billion tree tsunami project. You can read more on that. So while there are major global projects going on, we need local efforts too. So you and I, we have to do what we can. We should be more mindful of the water we use, recycle the grey water if possible. We should be mindful when we purchase, right from the plastic packeted food, from the clothes we buy, whatever, you know, books we buy. Be mindful that we don't create more waste at the source. You all have learnt about the, you know, reduce, reuse, recycle efforts. Now we have to add refuse at the beginning and repair too. So let's keep adding value to the life of a product before turning it into waste. Let's be mindful of the electricity we use. Let's make sure we reduce fuel usage. Talk to your family people. Have more conversation. Let's use more public transport. So these are the tiny things which we can do and create big changes. You should walk the talk and talk the walk. Create more circles of conversation, because it is important because you as future citizens, you need to have a healthy blue planet to live in. Climate change is dancing through our houses. We are seeing the impacts, floods, hurricanes, forest fires. Every month we see these things happening on the news globally. Kerala bore the brunt of the floods in 18 and 19. And now globally we are going through this pandemic. Even though not a direct impact of climate change, the pollution, the emissions we have created is adding to the worse. And as I said, the most vulnerable are being affected. So let's take a pledge that we will be more aware, more mindful of our living styles, that we will do what we can and walk forward to create a better planet, to work towards, you know, creating more balanced ecosystem that we live in. And that is why the tagline the UN is putting forth is reimagine, recreate and restore. So good day to you all. Thank you.
Thank you, ma'am, for those inspiring words. As students, we must reimagine, recreate and restore the planet which is the need of the earth. When I say reimagine, I ask you to imagine a new planet which is resourceful not only for the present but also for the future. Let us now watch what our friends think about the nature and what little but huge steps they have taken to protect our Mother Earth.
Namaste. World Environment Day is celebrated on June 5th globally. It is a day on which we spread awareness about the environment and the need to conserve it. The theme for 2021 is Ecosystem Restoration. On this occasion, UN Decade of Ecosystem Restoration will also be launched. Our environment is one of the most important aspects to survive on this planet. Moreover, it's only the thing that can make life sustainable. Let's take a pledge today that we will be frontline warriors to protect our earth and environment. Thank you.
will witness the launch of the UN Decade on Ecosystem Restoration, which is a rallying call for protection and revival of ecosystems all around the world for the benefits of people and nature. Ecosystem restoration means assisting in the recovery of ecosystem that has been degraded or destroyed, as well as conserving the ecosystem that are still intact. Friends, now let us listen to a song by Vishal SJ of Class 9A.
ഒരു തൈ നടുന്നു നാളെ മണ്ണിൽ ഒരു വസന്തോത്സവം തീർക്കാൻ ഒരു തൈ നടുന്നു നാം നാളെ മണ്ണിൽ ഒരു വസന്തോത്സവം തീർക്കാൻ മറയുന്ന മാമഴക്കാടിനെ മയങ്ങുന്ന പുഴകളെ ഒക്കെ വിളിച്ചുണർത്താ മറയുന്ന മാമഴക്കാടിനെ മയങ്ങുന്ന പുഴകളെ ഒക്കെ വിളിച്ചുണർത്താ ഒരു തൈ നടുന്നു നാം ഒരു തൈ നടുന്നു നാം നാളെ മണ്ണിൽ ഒരു വസന്തോത്സവം തീർക്കാൻ കനിവത്ത കാലം കരിച്ച വർണ്ണാഭമം ശലഭജന്മങ്ങളെ വീണ്ടെടുക്കാൻ കനിവത്ത കാലം കരിച്ച വർണ്ണാഭമം ശലഭജന്മങ്ങളെ വീണ്ടെടുക്കാൻ അകലെ മറഞ്ഞോരു തുമ്പികളെയോ മന കിളികളെയൊക്കെ തിരിച്ചു കിട്ടാൻ അകലെ മറഞ്ഞോരു തുമ്പികളെയോ മന കിളികളെയൊക്കെ തിരിച്ചു കിട്ടാൻ ഒരു തൈ നടുന്നു നാം ഒരു തൈ നടുന്നു നാം നാളെ മണ്ണിൽ ഒരു വസന്തോത്സവം തീർക്കാൻ മറയുന്ന മാമഴക്കാടിനെ മയങ്ങുന്ന പുഴകളെ ഒക്കെ വിളിച്ചുണർത്താ ഒരു തൈ നടുന്നു നാളെ മണ്ണിൽ ഒരു വസന്തോത്സവം തീർക്കാൻ മധുരമാം തോപ്പുകൾ മുക്കുറ്റിമുറ്റങ്ങൾ കറുക വരമ്പുകൾ വീണ്ടെടുക്കാൻ മധുരമാം തോപ്പുകൾ മുക്കുറ്റിമുറ്റങ്ങൾ കറുക വരമ്പുകൾ വീണ്ടെടുക്കാൻ തിരുതി മുറിയാതെ തിമർത്തു പെയ്യും പ്രിയ തിരുവാതിരകൾ തിരിച്ചു കിട്ടാൻ തിരുതി മുറിയാതെ തിമർത്തു പെയ്യും പ്രിയ തിരുവാതിരകൾ തിരിച്ചു കിട്ടാൻ ഒരു തൈ നടുന്നു നാം ഒരു തൈ നടുന്നു നാം നാളെ മണ്ണിൽ ഒരു വസന്തോത്സവം തീർക്കാൻ മറയുന്ന മാമഴക്കാടിനെ മയങ്ങുന്ന പുഴകളെ ഒക്കെ വിളിച്ചുണർത്താ ഒരു തൈ നടുന്നു നാളെ മണ്ണിൽ ഒരു വസന്തോത്സവം തീർക്കാൻ വേരുകൾ തമ്മിൽ പിണച്ചു പിടിച്ചു കൊണ്ട് മണ്ണു കാക്കുന്ന നാളെ എത്താൻ വേരുകൾ തമ്മിൽ പിണച്ചു പിടിച്ചു കൊണ്ട് മണ്ണു കാക്കുന്ന നാളെ എത്താൻ ഓരോ തനുവിലും ഓരോ പുൽത്തുമ്പിലും പൂവുകൾ പാടുന്ന നാളെ എത്താൻ ഓരോ തനുവിലും ഓരോ പുൽത്തുമ്പിലും പൂവുകൾ പാടുന്ന നാളെ എത്താൻ ഒരു തൈ നടുന്നു നാം ഒരു തൈ നടുന്നു നാം നാളെ മണ്ണിൽ ഒരു വസന്തോത്സവം തീർക്കാൻ മറയുന്ന മാമഴക്കാടിനെ മയങ്ങുന്ന പുഴകളെ ഒക്കെ വിളിച്ചുണർത്താ ഒരു തൈ നടുന്നു നാളെ മണ്ണിൽ ഒരു വസന്തോത്സവം തീർക്കാൻ ഒരു വസന്തോത്സവം തീർക്കാൻ ഒരു വസന്തോത്സവം തീർക്കാൻ.
It was indeed mesmerizing. There is life in the soil of every man. There is healing in the trees for tired minds and overburdened spirits. There is strength in the hills if only we lift our eyes. Remember that nature is your greatest restorer. I would feel more optimistic about a brighter future for man if he spent less time proving that he can outwit nature and more time tasting her sweetness and respecting her seniority. By E.B. White. Thank you.